Fresno State, I think, was the best choice for me. It's here in the valley. It's in the epicenter of where agriculture is going on. So I think I couldn't have made a better choice. What sparked the interest for me in agriculture was probably back in middle school. My dad and I started doing some landscaping on the side. In high school, I got involved with FFA. And so that kind of from there, it took off and I knew my career path had to do something with agriculture. My impression was this was the place to be. This is where, you know, not only was it close to home, but they have a great staff, teachers, they have a lot of experience. And so just coming here and visiting and seeing the campus and seeing, you know, the farm they have here, the variety of crops, what I wanted to do after college was become a licensed pest control advisor and eventually get my certified crop advisor certification. So pretty much all the classes that I've taken here have pretty much, you know, prepared me. I'm recently employed with Family Tree Farms. They're a farming operation out of Goshen. And pretty much what my task there is working alongside with their PCA. And so part of that involves me going into the fields, checking fruit, checking what the pest populations are, seeing what the pressure's like, checking traps. So pretty much getting an idea of what's out there, anything that's gonna harm the fruit. And you kind of just wanna have a good eye on that and be able to use that as far as planning your treatments. Here also I've had the opportunity to do the same thing in one of my classes, Integrated Pest Management. We had a class project where we were assigned a block out here and our task was to monitor pest population and seeing what the pressure's like. And so all that has, you know, helped me as far as where I'm at now. I know what to do. I know what are the key pests to look at. I think the funnest part as far as being a plant science major is everyone's really tight-knit. Everyone knows each other. Everyone works together. The teachers are awesome. You can always approach them, talk to them if you have any questions. Plant Science Club, that kind of gives people an opportunity to kind of get involved not only with school but also in the community. So as far as community service, being involved, like they have the Valley Farm Zoo. And so it kind of gives students an opportunity to not only just learn in class, but also be able to apply it. We have like our crop project where we grow different crops. And then at the end, we sell those at the Gibson Farm Market. And then those funds are then used to go to conferences. In the next 5 years, I see myself being a pest control advisor. So I look forward to working with the company where I'm at now, and being able to assist them in meeting their goals and demands and just being a resource for them. I think I've had a lot of memorable experiences here at Fresno State. I think the one that kind of stands out above all of them has to be when we attended the conference in Long Beach, the Tri-Society Conference. And there I had the opportunity to compete in the President's Trophy speech. There we were competing against schools like Texas A&M, Cornell, Kansas State, Purdue, so a bunch of big schools, agricultural schools from the Midwest. And I remember a couple of days before that, you know, we're getting that ready, staying up late, practicing, rehearsing, and it all paid off. We walked away with first place and brought the trophy back home. We're kind of giving an overview of what the Plant Science Club here at Fresno does. So we talked about, you know, what we do to promote the importance of agriculture, our community service, what we do as far as fundraising, and so stuff like that. So pretty much just showcasing the club here. There's a lot of people I'd like to thank. Everyone's played a very critical role in everything, and as far as me reaching this milestone of, you know, graduating from college. First of all, I'd like to thank my family. Both my mom and dad, they've been, I mean, as far as what I am today is because of them. Both mom and dad are from Mexico. They're from the state of Jalisco. And so they immigrated here, and my dad was a farm worker, and he was also involved in the dairy industry. He was a milker. And then all myself and my other five brothers were born here. I think it's cool that, you know, I'm kind of able to follow those footsteps. Early on, you know, he showed my brothers and I how to work, and I think, to me, it has a lot of value, because not only are you able to earn some money, but it teaches you responsibility, and also, you know, to be thankful for the little that you have. And I mean, to me, the way I look at it is, and the way my dad kind of wanted to put it to us was, hey, look, if you don't go to school or you don't get a career or do something with your life, this is what you're going to be doing. So, you know, to me, school, it's like, hey, I'd be here any day, and, you know, you just got to put in the effort, and it's doable. Whenever he was still around, I would, you know, share with him kind of what I was learning in the classroom. And to this day, you know, I wish he was still alive and I can share some of the stuff that I've been learning, and maybe, you know, something that he can relate. And I'd like to thank all my brothers. They've all been very supportive. And I think I'm kind of the only one that kind of took the path of agriculture. My youngest brother, he's a student here, and he kind of took on or kind of followed my same footsteps, but he's doing ag business. Another very, very important aspect or people that I have to thank is all the teachers here at Fresno State. They've all planted a seed of knowledge in me that will continue to grow. So teachers like Dr. Shrestha, Dr. Roberts, Dr. Gonzalez, and on, all of them have been great. And I'd especially like to thank Marlene Miyasaki. She's been like a second mom to me. And I'm sure she is to a lot of the other students feel the same way. She's just a very great person, always willing to help. And I'd also like to thank everyone at the Ag One, Shannon Fast, Alcidia Gomes, and everyone there involved with their staff. And I'd also like to thank Mary Willis, because she was very instrumental as far as me being where I'm at today in my career. Being a first generation college student, it means a lot. If there's people that are looking forward to going to college and doing something, and, you know, just being able to attend college and get a degree, one thing I would say is it's doable. You just have to work hard at it. Whether you have the money or not, you gotta have the motivation, and you just gotta work hard towards it, and anything in life is achievable.